Valerie Schnell on News Radio 1110 KFAB.
66 now, Omaha Council Bluffs, 70 in Lincoln.
Schrock Innovations presents the Midwest's number one independent computer repair company with service centers in Lincoln, Omaha, Papillion, Des Moines, and across the country via the Schrock Desk. This is Compute This.
Good morning, folks, and welcome into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock, and I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company, where things are hopping and popping at all four service centers now. People are coming in to get ahead of the back-to-school rush, which is really interesting. It's really different this year. Normally, back-to-school is a very predictable thing. You know, just like, you know, Target gets the aisle that's normally like the Christmas section, and there's always the four-way cardboard floor display of spiral-bound notebooks of various flavors. And your Trapper Keepers are still... do they still make Trapper Keepers? I don't know. Now that you have your iPad Keeper, I guess. I don't know. But you know how it goes. It's the same thing every year. There's a box of wooden pencils. Is the lumber price thing causing pencil prices to go up? I don't know. But anyway, you get the idea. The same thing is happening at Schrock right now at all four of our locations. So, for example, our Lincoln location just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road is literally a mile from a school. So parents in that area are bringing their kids' computers in to get maintenance done and all kinds of stuff. In the Omaha Service Center, 168th and Burke, same thing. Getting ahead, getting in front of that rush of people that are going to come in, because each school district has different rules. Some districts are going to go to a hybrid remote and in-person teaching method. Some districts are going back in full force. Some districts are going back with masks or without masks. And the CDC guidance says, you know, wear a mask if it's Tuesday, but if it's Wednesday, you can breathe freely. You know, it's insane. So then in our Papillion location, 84th and Highway 370, again, we're about a mile and a half from a high school. We're 2 miles from several other schools. So again, parents coming in with computers, you know, the kids never come in with their computers. It's always the parents that come in, and they always bring the kid with them like they're trying to teach them a life lesson, like, take care of your stuff, little Johnny. And the kid just looks bored, you know, whatever. When do I get my computer back? I want to play Fortnite and Valorant. So then, of course, the newest location, Baby Schrock at 9500 University Avenue in West Des Moines, is seeing a very similar thing. Now, where we're located there, there's not a school within a mile or two, but what we see a lot, ironically, grandparents bringing their grandchildren's computers in for maintenance. So we're going to talk a little bit about that during the show today. Nothing crazy or anything, but just letting everybody know kind of what's going on and what the turnaround times and the schedules look like in the service centers. Now, last week on the show, we gave you a bunch of information on Windows 11 compatibility. So if you are curious about anything Windows 11, all of the current compatibility requirements are there. In a nutshell, if you missed it, there's a ton of requirements that mean most computers will not run Windows 11 automatically. That's the bad news. The good news is most computers can be made to run Windows 11 if, you know, we need to make them. You know, the even better news is that most of those requirements can be completely overridden through, you know, digital trickery. The problem, we've been down this road before. You know, we edit your registry, we delete a file, and suddenly, you know, Windows 11 works. And you say, oh, wow, Schrock, you guys are tech gods. This is amazing. Until the next Windows 11 feature upgrade comes out and it won't install because it says your computer's not compatible. Then, you know, well, you fixed it for me before. I guess I'll have to have you fix it again. And then after the fourth or fifth iteration, the fixes stop working because Microsoft's like, all right, we're going to put an end to this. And then people get upset with us because then they have to go to Windows 11, but they didn't want to go to Windows 11, and you get the idea. So we're really interested in finding permanent solutions to get people onto Windows 11. So our official position as a company at this point, to avoid as much customer confusion as possible and to improve the security of our customers, Windows 11 is a more secure operating system than Windows 10. It has been said that Windows 11 will pretty much obsolete every virus out there right now, which, of course, is an overstatement. It's an exaggeration. But, yeah, 99% of those viruses that are out there right now will not run on Windows 11 because of the way that the operating system uses virtualization to create capsules for each application to run in. So when you open Word, it's in its own little house, and it can't get out and go talk to Outlook unless you allow it to specifically. And then anything that you might, any kind of nastiness that you might get into your Word, like a macro or anything, can't go out and mess with anything else. So it's really, It's ingenious. It's really good. So it's going to be amazing the same way that Windows 7 was amazing from a security perspective after XP. So our official position is we want to get you into Windows 11 if we possibly can. Now, some computers won't run it. We can make those computers run it, and that's part of the determination we need to figure out. But we'd rather have that figured out now than later. So we are starting to check the compatibility of every computer in the service center that comes in the door to let you know on your receipt whether or not your computer is Windows 11 compatible out of the box. So happy stories there for everybody, and then, of course, what it would take to make your computer compatible. So we talked a lot about that as well. Now, we also told you about a lawsuit that the former President Trump has filed against pretty much every social media company. I think LinkedIn was exempted from it. I don't think they were getting sued, but pretty much every other, you know, Facebook, Twitter, you know, all the biggies, as well as the CEOs, both personally and professionally, of those companies are being sued for violating First Amendment speech rights. A lot of people were a little confused by this because, of course, these are private companies, and private companies can say anything they want. Well, we have an update on that story coming up on the program today. We explained it last week. We'll briefly explain the angle again about how it was happening. And it seemed to be a pretty thready angle. You know, it was a little sketch until the administration started talking about it. And now it's like, oh, no, that's legit. That's straight up what they're doing. So, yeah, that might actually have legs. So it's going to be interesting because everyone in the media poo-pooed that lawsuit. And last week on the show, we said, you know, hey, there might be something to this. It's getting kind of put down as a long shot, but we aren't so sure. So we're going to tell you an update on that, too, that's going to kind of make you laugh and shake your head. Also, the Kaseya attack. If you didn't hear about this, you know, this was basically there's a big company out there called Kaseya, and they make tools for other computer repair shops to use to help businesses automate IT tasks like installing updates. You know, rather than what we have done at Schrock in creating an independent program called Safe Upgrade that you choose to run on your computer as a consumer, the other path that we could have gone down is we could sell you a subscription where we manage all the stuff on your computer, and then we can remote in and do things when we want to, and your life is easy because you don't have to think about it, which is great, but you're outsourcing all of your security to another company. And then in turn, we would be outsourcing all of your security to yet another company because we're using their tools. Well, the tool got hacked, and it caused all these people to get ransomware infections. Quick update on that one is that the R Evil group that was responsible for that attack simply has disappeared off the face of the earth. All their websites are gone. It looks like there may have been some pressure behind the scenes, governmental pressure between governments to do something about this. And somebody may have done something, or they just renamed and became something different. The problem is some of those companies paid the ransom, and they have issues. And believe it or not, R Evil has a help desk. It's like, you know, R Evil, 1-800-R-EVIL. You can call them up when you're having trouble running the decryptor tool that you paid a ridiculous amount of money for, and they will kind of coach you through how to get your files back. Well, the decryptor tool stopped working, and they're not there anymore at the help desk, and people who paid the ransoms are pretty much just out now. And people who would want to pay the ransoms simply can't. So that's kind of interesting, but it's going to be an awesome, awesome show today. So first thing is the number to join us on the program, 888-250-2091. 888-250-2091 is the number to join us on the show. Ask a question, make a comment. We'll put you in the drawing for a $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. Good for anything your heart desires over at the service center. We'll draw for that at the end of the program. But if $25 is not enough to pique your interest, you know, this is an inflationary world we live in. I think it buys you about a half a gallon of milk now. So, you know, if that's not enough, if you need a little bit more, how does a free computer sound? That's right. You can go over to schrockinnovations.com right now. Well, I mean, if you're in front of a computer or a phone, you can. If you're driving, please, you know, have your passenger do it for you. But you can go to schrockinnovations.com and right center, boom, right at the top of the page, click here to win a free computer. You click there, it'll take you to a page to sign up to vote in the Best of Omaha competition. So click the link, go through the instructions. You have to create a little account. It's not a big deal. The account is created with us. And then we monitor all the extra things that you can do to get extra entries in the contest. So if your back-to-school plan involves getting a new computer for your student, Well, this could be a great opportunity to do that. So you vote in the Best of Omaha. That gets you 5 entries in the contest. There are several other things you can do, you know, like our page, like our posts, that kind of stuff. You can do those things. A review on Google would be amazing. You get like a huge number of entries if you do that. But last year we did have some people say, you know, hey, it'd be nice. I don't do the social media thing. I don't do the Google thing. It would be nice if there was a way for me to enter without having social media. So what we did this year is we said, take a picture of yourself at a Schrock location and then upload it. So you go back to our website and you click on the banner to win a laptop, and it gives you a box that you can upload your picture directly to us. And we're just curious about, I mean, please keep them appropriate and family friendly. You know, we don't want to see some crazy pictures, but we are kind of curious, you know, what we're going to get here. So if you take a picture of yourself in a Schrock location, you know, make it as funny as you want. You can bring Flat Stanley with you, whatever you need to do. But take a picture there, upload it, and that's worth a few more entries as well. We're going to draw for that at the end of the Best of Omaha voting and basically get that that computer awarded. It is our 2021 Resolute laptop, so it's a $600 laptop, guys. So it's nothing to sneeze at. It's definitely worth more than the $25 gift certificate, just in case you need it. 888-250-2091. Coming up on the program, guys, the Windows 10 2.1H2 update. So follow me on this one. 2.1 2021 H2, half two, is coming this fall, usually around October. We're going to give you an update on that. I mentioned we're going to tell you about the Trump lawsuit. Patch Tuesday was this previous Tuesday. We're going to tell you what to look for there. Also, beating the back-to-school rush. This is going to be a segment we do maybe a little halfway through the program just to kind of let you know what to expect so that you can plan accordingly before it's last minute and you're rushing around to do things. Also, does the Biden administration want to fact-check your SMS text messages? That was a story that came out last week. I was at camp, so I got my news in snippets. And every time I checked the news, there was something more like crazy. Like, we're going to send people door-to-door to vaccinate you. What? Next story. We're gonna read your text messages and then put a, if you're talking to a friend and you're giving them misinformation about things, we're gonna send a fact check to both of you so that both of you know that whoever sent the message is an idiot, basically. Oh, wow, that means you have access to my text messages? That's interesting. Then the next day, it's like, oh, yeah, Facebook is working with the administration directly hand in glove to identify posts the administration wants censored, and more importantly, posts that are getting censored that shouldn't be getting censored, so we can block, so we can prevent that from happening. Every single day, I was like, I was at camp for a week, and I'm like, I can't, this is why we can't have nice things, folks. I go away for a week, and then boom, all this news. Also, so we have a lot to cover today, so let's get started right away with the Windows 10 2.1H2 update that's coming this fall. Previously reported, the 2.1H2 update was going to make Windows 10 look exactly like Windows 11, which was going to be, you know, hecka confusing for everybody, because do you have Windows 10? Do you have Windows 11? We don't know. Windows 11 comes with new features that Windows 10 will not have. How do you know which one you've got? Well, good news, bad news. It is the 2.1H2 update is going to update your interface, but it is going to be different than Windows 11. So if you want the full benefit of Windows 11, of course, you're going to have to move to Windows 11. But we should be able to visually tell by looking at the computer whether or not you're on Windows 10, which is good news. That update is coming out in the fall. It's a little light on features, which you know seems logical, right? If you have a new version of Windows out and you have a new feature you want to deploy, would you spend the time deploying it on Windows 10, or would you just deploy it to Windows 11 and say, well, I guess you better upgrade? Why are there going to be, are there going to be more feature updates to Windows 10 between now and its sunset in 2025? Which, you know, guys, that's only like, what, 3.5 years from now? Oh, no, 4.5 years from now. No, 3.5 years from now. So that's not a long time. Are there going to be more feature upgrades? We don't know. Microsoft won't say. But the good news here is that you will be able to tell the difference. And that update's going to be coming out this fall, which, of course, there will be a safe upgrade to help you handle it. The interesting thing is, at the same time, you'll be able to decide whether you're going to upgrade to Windows 11. And we are not certain if there's going to be a safe upgrade for that one, if we want to try to run two concurrent safe upgrades with two different goals at the same time. It could get very confusing. So we're gonna come out with a way to handle that and try to preemptively get ahead of this as much as we can for our customers to make sure that your experience in migrating to Windows 11 is as seamless and painless as possible. All right, so that one is interesting. Now, the update on the Trump White House lawsuit thing. So if you recall, last week we reported that President Trump filed suit against a number of social media companies, he including their CEOs personally and professionally. He said they all violated First Amendment speech rights that are guaranteed by the Constitution. The government shall not or cannot infringe on these rights. Independent private companies can print whatever they want, though. They have a freedom of speech as well. So the argument is they're private companies. They can censor you if they want, Mr. President. So, you know, tough eggs. So, all right, well, guess what? So, of course, the booksellers chose not to sell the books. Well, it went all the way to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court ruled that if a city or a town or a municipality achieves censorship through basically onerous consequences of engaging in free speech, that private organization, the bookstores, are doing the work of the government. They're doing the censoring for the government, and it has the same chill effect on free speech as if the government did it itself, and it was orchestrated by the government. Therefore, it was the government that did it, and it is a violation of your First Amendment rights. Now let's fast forward to the present. Trump says, well, basically, the social media companies are working hand in glove with the Democrat Party and, by extension, the current administration to censor and chill conservative speech, to censor and chill speech of their opponents on the political spectrum and ideas that they don't agree with. Okay, I think we can all pretty much admit that that's going on, right? I don't see too many, you know, anti-Trump memes getting censored for being bullying and stuff like that. You know, it's pretty much one-sided. There are examples, of course, that you can cite of egregious things on both sides. But for the most part, the vast majority of stuff is focused on, you know, people who don't want to get vaccinated, people who don't think other people should get vaccinated, people who, you know, support President Trump, people who support less government, for example. Are now a targeted class, basically. So all these things are happening out there. And what Trump said in his lawsuit is that the administration, that the government is working hand in glove with the social media companies. They are directing the social media companies as to what content should be fact-checked, how it should be fact-checked, and why it should be fact-checked. And then the social media companies are executing at the government's request. He said this, the CDC is a great example. CDC says these things about the coronavirus, which eventually are proven not to be true or at least questionable. But nobody could point out that that doesn't make sense or that wasn't true, because if you did, you got censored. So that was the whole point of that lawsuit. Everyone said, this is pretty sketched. It's a little stringy. Literally, I go to camp. I'm chilling in a tent. I get up in the morning and I read the news, and guess what? The Biden administration says that they are working directly with Facebook. The White House is working directly with Facebook to identify posts that they consider to be misinformation and advising Facebook of those posts so they can be censored or fact-checked. Additionally, sometimes their posts are getting fact-checked, and they don't like that. They shouldn't be censored. So they're also advising Facebook which posts from the administration are getting fact-checked incorrectly and therefore should be allowed through. And Facebook is doing their requests. Literally, it was like 2 days later. Like, we all had a weekend party and everybody got drunk and forgot there was a lawsuit. And then they came out the next day and said, yeah, we're doing that. Totally doing that. And it's like, this is Exhibit 5422 in the lawsuit. Right there. I mean, that was, of course, all this is going to take a long time to get through the courts. It's filed in a very friendly court. It's going to take a while. It's not going to make any difference in anything for the 2022 election. But after that, you could start to see this case winding through where social media companies are basically forced to stop fact-checking anything because they're violating First Amendment speech. So it's a really interesting way to get from point A to point B, but it could be very effective. 888-250-2091 is the number to join us on the program. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, Patch Tuesday fixed 117 vulnerabilities. What you need to do right now to make sure that your computer is protected. Also, Gary, please stay on the line. Your call is coming up next on Compute This.
Schrock Innovations can't teleport technicians to you, but online help is only a click away with the Schrock Desk. Subscribe today and get unlimited help whenever you need it.
Remember the good old days when virus detection worked like Where's Waldo? Spot the virus in the striped shirt and you win. Today's infections are changing hourly to avoid detection and use social engineering to trick you into making mistakes. Using yesterday's security to defend against today's threats is like using leeches to stop an infection. It just doesn't work. We recommend Sophos Intercept X antivirus backed by Schrock's virus-free guarantee. Sophos uses the power of AI to detect the patterns of a virus attack and responds with Schrock's custom actions that stop it fast. With Sophos on your PC, Mac, Android, or iOS device, you get the state-of-the-art protection you need to defend against the most advanced attacks out there. In fact, if your device gets a virus while running Sophos antivirus, Schrock will remove it for free, guaranteed. It hasn't happened yet, and we intend to keep it that way. Ditch your dad's antivirus and keep your device, data, and identity safe with Sophos and Schrock Innovations.
Compute this pro tip 178. Those little life-saving surge protector strips are vital to your computer's health and should be used whenever possible, even for laptops. As computers get smaller and more powerful, they're also becoming more sensitive to dirty power, and your power is a lot dirtier than you might think. Even if you have a whole home surge protection, most power surges are generated within your own home. If you've ever vacuumed and seen the lights get dimmer and brighter, you created a surge. Surge protectors can only absorb so much energy measured in joules. When that capacity is exhausted, your surge protector becomes a glorified extension cord and needs to be replaced. You should always look for surge protectors that give audible alerts when they're no longer able to protect your equipment. Schrock recommends these because the lights on most strips are just power lights and they don't tell you when it's time to replace the unit. If in doubt, replace your surge protectors annually to keep your expensive TVs, computers, and other electronic equipment safe. This pro tip is brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Alrighty, folks, welcome back into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company, where we sell new laptops, new modular desktops. We fix all the other guys' stuff that isn't working right or is built with substandard parts. We recover data off failed hard drives. We'll come to your home for a free pickup or free drop-off to get your computer in for the work or maintenance that it needs. We'll drop it off again for free for you. That's within 30 miles of a service center. Or sometimes it's just easier if we come out to your house. We offer on-site services as well, where we come to you to make sure that your technology is doing exactly what you want it to do. The number to join us on the program today is 888-250-2091. We are broadcasting live this morning on Facebook at facebook.com/Schrock Innovations. Some of you have said, you know, I'm not going to use Facebook anymore. Those, you know, blah, 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 you know. Whatever. Everybody's got to complain about Facebook, right? Unfortunately, they do have the best video streaming platform for what we're trying to do here on the program. We do take these videos, however, and save them at schrockinnovations.com on Monday. So if you do want to watch the show or missed a piece of it and you want to pick up the video, as well as the After Schrock, which is only available on Facebook until we post the video, we do post it on YouTube and Rumble, and all that is available at schrockinnovations.com. Some people have reported this morning that the video feed's a little choppy. It looks like at the start of the show it was a bit choppy. We dropped 90 frames total, or about 0.8% of the total frames of the program. So it should be good now. So hopefully everybody's watching and doing it right. All right. Also, stay tuned after the show. We're going to do an After Schrock. As I mentioned, I spent the last week at a summer camp with my son. Tons of stories for you. Detached retinas. 24-hour stints, stims. I mean, oh, it was a camp out. Let me tell you what, those scouts know how to throw a party. So we got lots of stories for you in the After Schrock, which is a little show we do right after the program on facebook.com/Schrock Innovation. So do tune in for that if you have the time. All right, number to join us, 888-250-2091. Gary, thanks for holding there. How can I help you today on Compute This?
Oh, thanks for taking my call.
No problem.
What I'm going to be talking about, and it's kind of a two-part question. If you got time, I'd like to satisfy my curiosity why I had to do this. But it's a 2014 HP notebook, and it's still on Windows 8.1, and it's got a 64-bit operating system. Anyway, the HP and pre-installed CyberLink PowerDVD version 12 software decided, for whatever reason, it needed an activation code after it had been working. So hastily, I went to Videoland's website, and I downloaded the latest version of the VLC player for Windows.
Perfect.
Anyway, I didn't realize until later that you have to kind of dig in the weeds to find the 64-bit version. So the default thing that came up, I downloaded the 32-bit version. So my question is, should I uninstall that and reinstall the 64-bit version? It seems to be working fine. And then as a side note, that CyberLink Power DVD version that was pre-installed, that's a 32-bit version
right.
that HP put on there.
You know, I would encourage you to, when you have the time, it'll work fine right now. It'll work fine as long as you're on Windows 10. Windows 11 is switching to a purely 64-bit OS. So the OS will be 64-bit. 32-bit programs will still be backward compatible, but we see which way the ball is going here. So if you have the choice between 32-bit and 64-bit, I would always select 64-bit at this point, but your 32-bit software should work just fine.
Yeah, it seems to work fine, but do you got time for the second part of this?
I have about 30 seconds.
Okay, well, I did do a restore on this laptop. I was going to get rid of it last year through a charity auction, and then COVID stopped it. But anyway, when I went to play a DVD, and it had worked before, CyberLink come up and said they needed an activation code.
Yep.
It's never been activated. So I jumped through their hoops, and I get a message saying this activation service is no longer available. Upgrade to the full version to get playback support and more. So did that restore wipe out that activation code that was in that?
Yeah,
initially,
unfortunately, your original PC paperwork came with either a cyber disk that had a code on the envelope, but that's usually how they did it, or it was pre-activated by HP when you got it. So when you did the restore, that can wipe out that code. And unfortunately,
okay.
The software is probably old enough now that they've replaced it with three or four new versions. So
right, they are, yep.
Windows has everything you need inside of it to burn anything you need to burn. And the CyberLink software was purely there to give you a media player because Windows 10 doesn't come with a media player. But VLC does all the media playing functions that program would have done, and you just installed that. So I think you're good to go. I think you're going to be just fine.
All right. Appreciate that.
Hey, thank you for the call, Gary. And we got you in the drawing as well for that meager $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. If that doesn't float your boat, go to schrockinnovations.com and click on the button there to enter to win a free $600 Resolute laptop just by participating in the Best of Omaha competition. We would really appreciate your vote for Omaha's best computer repair. Although we don't know who you vote for, if you just vote, we just know you voted, okay? If you vote, you're in the contest. We would hope that you would vote for us, but, we humbly ask for your vote. 888-250-2091. Patch Tuesday happened while I was at camp as well. Yay! Everything happened while Thor is gone. This is great. So Patch Tuesday, there was 117 vulnerabilities patched, basically tons of stuff. And this came a week after Microsoft released an emergency patch. It patched Office, like Excel, Word, all that stuff, Exchange Server. Windows Defender even got a patch. Not that you should use that, but it got a patch. All kinds of stuff there patched up. If you have not restarted, actually want to fact check, or can they actually fact check the text messages that you send, like a husband and wife sends each other from their phones? Can the Biden administration put a fact check right in between those two messages? We're going to tell you what's going on with that coming up next on Compute This.
If you can dream it, Schrock Interactive's website developers can make it happen. Refresh your website, automate sales and marketing, and grow your business today with Schrock Interactive. External hard drives are handy. You can back up multiple computers to them or even use them to move lots of data from one computer to another. Computer users have been buying the same old external hard drives for years. While our computers have been getting faster, we still do backups that take hours or watch epic progress bars creep by to move files. Schrock wanted more for our customers, so our innovators created the fastest external hard drives on the planet. Schrock modular storage devices are up to 50% faster than Seagate or Western Digital externals and are modular in the truest sense of the word. We can create whatever size and speed of drive you need for all of your needs, and all modular storage devices come with a data restoration guarantee. If you use our drives for backing up and your computer's hard drive fails, we'll restore your backup to your repaired computer for free. Fast, simple, and flexible technology solutions from Schrock Innovations. It's what we do. Compute this pro tip number 753. Have you ever wondered how the bad guys always seem to find a way into your computer? Gone are the good old days of email worms and I love you viruses. Nobody wants to steal your data anymore, or in many cases, even your identity. Today's cyber criminals want to sell access to your computer or hold your data for ransom. The bad guys are exploiting zero-day vulnerabilities to break into systems that are supposed to be hack-proof. These vulnerabilities are always newly discovered, and the criminals have a brief time to exploit them before they get patched. Antivirus and firewalls do not prevent these attacks, but you can minimize your computer's exposure by installing all security patches as quickly as possible. The average computer needs 12 patches a week. That's not including the ones that are automatically delivered to your computer. Boost your cybersecurity by staying on top of it manually or use a patch installation program like Secure Updater to get your computer the patches it needs. This pro tip is brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Fox News, I'm Karen McHugh. President Biden says the Justice Department is working to appeal a federal judge's decision on DACA.
The DACA program has been controversial since its inception in 2012. Now a federal judge in Texas says it's illegal and that the government can no longer accept applications from so-called dreamers. Texas was among the states suing to block the measure, and the state's attorney general, he tweeted his reaction saying, "I think it's right to stop a president who just decided that he didn't like federal law and came up with his own immigration laws. We sued him, rightfully so, for violating federal law, and we won."
Fox's Mark Meredith. Three people were hurt last night outside of the Washington Nationals ballpark during a drive-by shooting. As for those inside the stadium,
at no time during this incident were individuals inside the stadium attending the game in any type of danger.
D.C. Metro Police Chief Robert Conti. America is listening to Fox News.
Now, the News Radio 1110 KFAB Weather Watch.
Mostly to partly cloudy skies today with high temperatures climbing back into the low to mid 80s. We do have the chance for some scattered showers or thunderstorms during the morning and early afternoon, primarily west of the Omaha Metro. We'll drop back down into the mid 60s tonight, partly cloudy with a high near 86 on Monday. With Omaha's most accurate forecast, I'm 6 News First Alert meteorologist Mallory Schnell on News Radio 1110 KFAB.
Alrighty, folks. Man, it's hard to believe that the show's half over already. I'm having such a good time. Thanks for being with us today for Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company, and we love what we do. In fact, if you are looking for a job, because, you know, if you're not on unemployment right now and you really want a job, you don't just want an interview so you can keep your unemployment, because that's pretty much what we're getting. 80% of the people who apply for jobs ghost the interview. You don't even have to attend the interview. In fact, I was talking to a restaurant owner, or a restaurant manager yesterday, and he said that when people, when he says, okay, we'll give you an interview, he calls them now. He doesn't send them the email saying schedule a time for an interview, because all you need is that email to prove that you had an interview. So now he calls, and the people will ask him on the phone, can you send me an email confirming the date and time for the interview? And he says, no, I'm sorry, we don't do that. And then, basically, don't waste my time. You know, if you're just not going to show up, or you're going to show up and then not show up for the job, or would not take the job because you don't want it, you know, whatever. So basically, we need a couple more front desk people for our service centers. We need a Lincoln front desk. We have Addie over there right now, who has done a bang up job for us for a number of years, and we love her to death. But she is at the studio. So basically, it looks like the video may be hiccuping a little bit on Facebook. I lost my remote connection to my computer here. So folks, this is live radio, and we are now flying without a net. All right. If you want to fly with me, 888-250-2091 is the number to join us on the program. Before we jump into the back-to-school rush stuff, I want to make sure I talk about Drive Advisor. Drive Advisor is, while I was gone, I had sporadic access to email. And so it's always that overwhelming crush that you get when you check your email, and it's like 147 new messages. Oh, boy. And so you go through and you start deleting the ones that are obvious spam, anything with a Cyrillic character in it, you know, you get rid of all those. And then, you know, you start going back through, and I'm left with I get a copy of all the Drive Advisor emails when your drives fail. And the reason I get a copy is I'm a catch-all. I make sure that somebody calls you when your main C drive is failing. If it's your D drive or your E drive or your K drive or something, you know, we don't really bug you over that. But when it's your C drive, where your operating system and your important files are stored, we actually pick up the phone and call you if you're a Schrock customer, because then otherwise we don't have your phone number, right? But if you bring your computer into the service center and we install Drive Advisor for you, we obviously have your phone number. So we pick up the phone and call you and tell you, hey, your hard drive is failing. You can do with that information what you want. Some people choose to allow it to continue to fail. I'm just going to run this one into the dirt and buy a new one. That's legit. All right. We had one guy who was from Chicago, actually, who was just in town for a business something or other. And we installed Drive Advisor on his computer like 2 years ago. And we told him at the time we installed it, because we tell everybody. And he'd forgotten. He got irate. You're tracking my computer, knowing everything I'm doing. I didn't authorize that. You get this stuff off my computer. Well, you know, we're not tracking you. You know, we don't know what you're doing with your computer. We don't know. The only thing we know is that your hard drive is not operating at 100% health. And you're obviously in Chicago. You're not in our service area. So you should take it to your computer repair center of choice. The idea here is to prevent downtime. And if you'd like to, we can't uninstall you. Point in case. We can't uninstall it from your computer because we don't have access to your computer. But you can uninstall it. It's called Drive Advisor. Just uninstall it if you don't want it. But your hard drive is bad. Well, so we called him up and told him that. Well, then his hard drive got worse. So as your hard drive degrades further, we give you an additional call. Like, hey, stop trying to back stuff up. I know you're trying to do that right now, but you just ran a backup and your hard drive's health dropped another 5%. Stop it. We will back it up for you. We'll copy it to a whole stable drive and everything. Please bring it in. So, of course, this guy in Chicago, we'll call him Chicago Man. Chicago Man, we get another alert that his hard drive goes down even further. So a different front desk, a different person says, oh, I better make sure he gets a call, not knowing that he was called the day before. Oh, wow, he tore her face off. And it was just one of those things where you just shake your head and you're like, you're trying to do nice things for people. And this is the thanks you get. You know, no good deed. But Drive Advisor is a very good deed, and I would encourage you to have it on all of your computers. In fact, you don't even have to come into the service center to get it. It's available completely free on the internet at driveadvisor.com. That's DriveAdvisor, Advisor. And we named it that because it's made in America. And you can install that on your computer. It'll monitor your hard drive. That's all it does. It sends us basically technical data about your computer's health, and that's it. And then the automated system, you know, we have an algorithm. No human being ever looks at your hard drive health data. Not that we can't, because, of course, anyone who tells you that they can't is an idiot. You know that if the CEO of Google wants to see someone's search data, that someone's going to show it to him. You know that's going to happen, right? If you call us and say, what's the health of my hard drive? We can look up your account and tell you the health of your hard drive. But we're monitoring over 14,000 computers, and honestly, it gets really boring to look at the status of people's hard drives when all you can look at is the health status, right? There's no reason to look at it. So yes, we could look at it, but we only do when our automated system flags your drive because it's failing. And then you're really glad that you have Drive Advisor because it keeps you out of that expensive data recovery lab. Even though Schrock does it for half the price of the national competitors, half of $1,300 is still painful, right? So let's keep you out of there, especially if your computer's under warranty, right? Then we clone it and replace it for free. It's amazing stuff. So definitely check out Drive Advisor at driveadvisor.com. 888-250-2091. Gordon, welcome to the program. How can I help you today on Compute This?
So I've got a Pixel 2 phone, and I noticed that I can't, it won't give me any more software updates. Do I need to get a new phone?
A Pixel 2. Let me see. Do you know what version of Android that's running?
No, I'd have to look at it, and I'm talking to you on it.
Oh, well, then it's hard to look at it when it's against your ear, right? Let's
yeah.
See. It looks like the Pixel 2 and the Pixel 2 XL have reached end of life. Only one more update was planned, and that was as of October 5th of 2020. So looks like the Pixel 2, no guaranteed security updates after October of 2020. And so the Pixel 3 expires in 2021, the Pixel 4 in 2022. I think you get the pattern here. The Pixel 5 in 2023. So, yes, your phone has reached the end of life cycle, and I literally got a security patch update for my Samsung Galaxy phone this morning. So I know they're running the same base Android OS. So I can guarantee you that there are security patches that you don't have on your phone right now.
Okay. So... is there any way to fake it out to make it think that it's a Pixel 5?
Not that I'm aware of. Not that I'm aware of. There, you can definitely root the phone and install a custom ROM, but the problem you're going to come up against is that there were security improvements introduced in later versions of Android OS that are going to cause the phone, the hardware, to work differently and not properly. So unfortunately, you're going to be looking at another phone. But I did see an article about the latest Pixel phone actually being really good. So if you wanted to stay with the Pixel phone, Pixel is made by Google, basically. It's like the test phone for Android. Google makes them. You order them. They ship them to you. If you don't know what a Pixel is, you're not going to be able to buy one at the store. But if you wanted a good flagship smartphone, they're very nice phones. Samsung hasn't beat on cameras because Samsung's trying to beat Apple on cameras. Apple's camera smokes the Pixel's camera. So you don't always get the best hardware, but the price of the Pixel phone is sometimes as much as 50% cheaper than a flagship phone. So it's a six of one, half a dozen. If you're a professional photographer, you wouldn't be using a phone anyway. So, but I have to tell you, when the giant snapping turtle crawled into our campsite and started exploring Scout's tents, you better believe I was glad that I had a really, I mean, this thing was huge. Its neck was like 3 inches thick. Its tail was like almost a foot long. Big spikes, looked like a dinosaur. It was crazy. Crawling right under the rainflies of the tents. I filmed that with my Samsung phone, and I was glad that I had image stabilization at a 10x zoom. That it was great. So those features do come in handy for those snapping turtle situations, but most people don't use them very often at all.
Right. So it's time to get a new phone is what you're saying.
Yeah, I think it's time. It's time, Gordon. I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, I appreciate it.
All right. Hey, thank you for the call, Gordon. I appreciate you joining us on the program today. Glad we could help you out with your technology a little bit. 888-250-2091 is the number. All right. So back to school. Back to school happens every time. You know, every school starts at a slightly different time. You know, we are our family is in the Papillion-La Vista School District. And, you know, there is still some debate. The CDC recommended that all unvaccinated children wear masks, which would basically be anyone under 12. You know, we have a special needs kiddo, and that's why she's going to Papillion-La Vista. All of our other kids are homeschooled, but she's going to Papillion-La Vista because she needs those services. Ironically, if Papillion-La Vista submits a reimbursement form to the state government for services rendered, they get the money from the state government, no questions asked. But if we try to do the same thing and provide those services at home with a private professional, we are denied. So we have to put her in the school district. And the people there are, you know, like any school district, there are some really great people there. And there's also a few people that, you know, are probably, let's just say, closer to retirement than they may think. you know, so it's, you know, it's six of one, half a dozen of the other. But when you have a kid who's speech impaired, who's speech delayed, and, you know, everybody's wearing masks, it makes doing speech therapy very hard. For example, apparently she wasn't putting the K on the end of milk. So she was saying mill. I'd like some mill. And she just wasn't adding the K. So they started saying milk. So guess what she does now? Yeah, she's learned to double pronounce the last consonant of any word. And so because she couldn't see them doing the enunciation on the end of the word, she developed another like auditory tic that we're working out of her through the summer here. So it's not milk. I'd like more milk, please. You know, it's just milk. So anyway, so the masks in our district, it's a CDC guidance, but it's not a requirement. So we don't know exactly what's going to happen. And I suspect that we're in the same position as a lot of parents whose children are going back to public school that are probably going back full time and that that may or may not have to wear masks and everything like that. So back to school is going to be really weird for a lot of people this year. Is the school offering at home options? There are some parents who are completely terrified to send their children back to school because, you know, the Delta variant is out there and they're worried that their kids are going to become carriers and bring it home or, you know, whatever the case might be. So some parents actually want to keep their kids out in the hybrid model. And so some schools might be offering some of this and some of that. The bottom line is when COVID hit last year, the first thing that went were all the good mid-range computers, all of your i3s and your, you know, your, I don't know, i5s to an extent. Which left you with the really, really low-end stuff, the Celeron computers and the Chromebooks, or the really, really high-end stuff, the gaming computers. So, of course, the next thing that went were the cheap ones. They sold out completely, leaving just the gaming computers, which is why when you went to buy a computer during COVID, you found you had to spend $1,000 to $1,500 on a computer. That has come down quite a bit since COVID, but the prices of computers are still elevated. Just take a trip to Best Buy if you're bored on a Friday night, and you can see the prices of computers have gone up and the selection is way down. Heck, I went to a Walmart near the camp where we were at, and I hadn't been into I've been to our neighborhood Walmart, which is one of the smaller ones, but I hadn't been to like a big Walmart. I was shocked how bare the shelves were. I mean, the supply challenges are real. Prices are real, guys. So long story short here, the same thing is going to happen for back to school. Lots of people bought really cheap, junky, non-upgradable computers just to do Zoom calls for back to school. parents are going to try to take those Zoom computers or those Chromebooks and use them for regular schoolwork this year. And they're going to find, shockingly, that they're very limited. And therefore, they need to buy new computers. And when that happens, we're going to see another little supply run. We're going to see basically the supply chain constricting a little bit. It'll be very temporary, a month, maybe two, but we are stocked up for it over at Schrock Innovation. So if you're thinking about a new computer for a child, your son, your daughter, your grandson, your granddaughter, niece and nephew to go back to school, I would encourage you to do it sooner rather than later. You don't have to give it to them right now, but I would encourage you to pick it up and get it while all the supplies are still able to be ordered. We're still getting quantity limited when we ordered some Asus laptops to 2 units a week. So we're able to keep up right now on some models, but sometimes it gets to be a little challenging. So make sure that you're getting your maintenance done. Make sure you're getting those computers purchased ahead of the rush. We expect the rush to start in earnest here the last week of July into the first 2 weeks of April, or excuse me, of August. 888-250-2099. We're going to take the final break of the program, but when we come back, I read, because I couldn't get very much signal, a disturbing report about the White House, the Biden administration, wanting to fact check SMS messages between private individuals. So if a husband and a wife are sending text messages back and forth, and one of them says, "You couldn't pay me to get that vaccine, it's not safe," then somehow a government fact check message is going to appear on both screens indicating that the previous message is not true. And here's why. The CDC says, and that was shocking to me. I was like, number one, they can do that? How are they doing that? So we're going to tell you exactly what's going on, how it's happening, or how it might happen when we come back next on Compute This.
Drive Advisor is a free program from Schrock Innovations that monitors your hard drive's health and tells you if it's going bad. Download it for free at driveadvisor.com. Schrock Innovations has spent nearly 2 decades working to make your technology life easier. And the all-new SchrockInnovations.com is no exception. Now you can order new modular computers and solid-state laptops directly from our website, secure your computer with our virus-free guaranteed semantic endpoint software, find innovative new technologies like our modular storage devices, and get free help and tips. Take a look at the specials section to find sales on one-of-a-kind items, display models, refurbished units, and our latest special offers. Swing by the Compute This page to watch TV segments and archived radio shows, or even get one-on-one help through the Schrock Desk. As always, we respect your privacy, so we secure our website with the latest encryption technology and only the most secure payment methods. You can pick up your purchases at any of our 3 service centers or have them shipped directly to your door. The new SchrockInnovations.com makes technology simple. It's what we do. And now, Compute This pro tip number 373. Everyone knows we're supposed to back up our computers and then check those backups periodically to make sure they're working. So why don't most people do it? Lots of people have different ideas about what backing up means. Is it copying files to a flash drive? Is it using a fancy backup program? And how do you know it's working anyway? Windows makes backups easy through free software that's already on your computer. Open your control panels and click Update and Security. Select Backup and choose from all of the available options to get a regular, reliable checkup. You'll need something to back up to, like a Schrock modular storage device or some other backup hard drive. Backups usually run once a week, but you can always change the frequency. The best part is that if your backup ever fails, you'll see a notification in the lower right corner by your clock telling you something's up. Backing up your important data has never been easier. So take a moment to back up your computer today. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Alrighty, folks, welcome back into Compute This final segment of the program. Man, this hour has just flown by. This is called withdrawal. I haven't been able to talk with you for so long, I feel like, you know, and so now I've been surrounded by children for a week, and now I have adults to talk to. This is amazing. All right. So, big story came out while I was gone about it was a Politico story. So that was one of the things that really kind of flagged it for me. Like, this is not like some kooky right-wing website saying, oh, they're going to read your text messages and, you know, go to the bunker now. You know, it's not like that. It was actually Politico that reported that Democrats want to fact-check your text messages, and they're going to do this by working hand-in-hand with the SMS service carriers. So they're going to work with Verizon and, you know, T-Mobile and AT&T to basically monitor text messages so they can fact-check them. Now, this struck me as weird because, number one, this would tend to, you'd have to assume, it's kind of like if you're going to go door to door to visit the unvaccinated, you have to assume there's a list of unvaccinated people somewhere, right? Unless they're just, unless there's other, that's an aftershock story. I'll tell you about that one in the aftershock. That's not what they're doing when they're going door to door, by the way. But if you're going to intercept people's text messages, that tells you there's infrastructure in place to intercept text messages, which I'm sure we assume the NSA can do that. But all the same, it would be really nice if, you know, private stuff is private. Now, we all know that text messages transit the cellular network unencrypted. They are not a safe way to send anything. You should assume that anything you send in a text message can and is being read by a man in the middle. So you never send a credit card number. You never send a password. You never, you know, text message is not safer than a phone call. A phone call is far safer than a text message. Now, that's one of the reasons why I installed Signal on my phone. Signal is an app that you can get. It's free. It's a 501c3 charity, so I do make an annual $25. You know, I give them something because I'm using their service and I feel like, you know, they're providing a good service. I want to support them. But Signal allows completely encrypted end-to-end text messaging. So I replaced my default app. And if anyone that I'm texting has Signal installed as well, our Signal apps automatically take over the conversation. And so for our shops, all my managers use Signal. And then if they need a card to buy something, I can literally take a picture of the credit card and text it to them because it's all encrypted. Well, your text messages are not. Now, one exemption here is if one iPhone user is messaging another iPhone user and you're using iMessage and not the SMS network, which doesn't always happen by default, then your messages are secure between iPhones, but not if they go through an SMS network first. So it depends on if you have a roaming signal. There's a lot of factors here. So fact check. USA Today, we can always count on them to fact check, you know, truth to power, the whole bit here. Fact check. Biden does not want to monitor private text for vaccine misinformation. The claim. Biden want. It sounds so derisive. Biden, that president guy wants phone companies to monitor people's texts for vaccine information. A July 12th article about the Biden administration's response to vaccine disinformation, Politico reported that groups allied with President Joe Biden are working with text message carriers to fight the spread of vaccine misinformation. Biden allied groups, including the Democrat National Committee, are also planning to engage fact checkers more aggressively and work with SMS carriers to dispel information. Okay, so they say that this is false. Okay. Here is the three on-fire rings they had to jump through to get to a false. Number one, it's not Biden. He doesn't know what's going on. Let me rephrase that. He is not involved with the decisions of the Democrat National Committee. He's not involved in any way. That would be illegal, right? You can't do that. So, number one, this is just the DNC. And we can trust the DNC to do what's in the best interest of the country because they are a political organization after all. Now, what they want to do is they want to basically lean on SMS providers because, for if you ever get a text message, those broadcast text messages, we've been trying to get a hold of you about your vehicle's extended warranty. That's the messages they want to target. Apparently, somebody somewhere is paying money to broadcast messages about vaccines. Who'd have knew? And so if you can't put it on the web and you want to, if you have an audience of people that you've set up, you get their phone numbers, you can create a text group and you can send out broadcast messages to this text group. Now, what ends it? So if I'm on Signal, I can do this. And unfortunately, if you're not on Signal and you're one of my customers, you would just get a regular SMS from me through the SMS network. What the DNC wants to do is they're going to have somebody who stealthily subscribes to all these lists. And when they receive these messages that are misinformation, they are going to report them back to the SMS carriers, the AT&Ts, Verizons, things like that, that this right here sent me a message with virus misinformation or something else we don't want told to people. Then the carriers will go back to the providers of the broadcast service and let them know that there's a problem with that particular customer who needs to be silenced. So you see, this is very much like social media, what's happened there, except the infrastructure isn't built for it yet. And that's what the DNC is trying to build right now, is a layer of fact-checking infrastructure for SMS messages. So while it is true that the Biden administration is not reading your SMS messages, it is also true that the DNC's eventual goal is to stifle speech they don't agree with, which they see as a political outcome to improve their opportunities to win elections. So there you go, guys. That's it's one of those things where those are some good link bait headlines. You know what link bait is? When you read a headline that says, Joe Biden wants to read your text messages, and you're like, oh, how dare him? Click, and you read that link, and you see all these ads. I'm looking at a Cabela's ad right now. What else have I got here? Oh, a solar generator. I was camping. I could have used that. All right. And that's called link bait, guys. So don't fall for link bait. You still got to think for yourself. Even if you're reading a website you agree with, the truth is usually somewhere in the middle. All right, I only have two people to choose from for the $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. So we're going to play a game of eeny, meeny, miny, moe and say, Gary, congratulations. You have won the $25 certificate. We'll get a hold of you on Monday to get that into your Schrock account so that it's available for you to use within 90 days at any service center. Guys, we are open Saturday from 10 in the morning until 8 in the evening, Sunday from noon to 5. Of course, every other day of the week, we're also open 10 to 8. Feel free to stop by, drop off your computers, get that maintenance done for school and your kids' computers. They will right now, turnaround times are 24 to 48. Promise we will not disrupt their Fortnite career. Thank you for joining us, guys. Stay tuned for the Aftershock on Facebook.com/Schrock Innovations. See you next weekend.
From the Amish Furniture of Nebraska studio, style you'll want, furniture you'll love. This is News Radio 1110.